Hey, what's up YouTube? So today TaiG released their 8.3 Jailbreak for Windows, and I am here on a Mac with a virtual machine of Windows, and I'm going to show you guys how to jailbreak error-free. This is a step-by-step. The first step is to completely restore this device, so whichever device you're wanting to use, to 8.3 stock. The second thing you're going to want to do is remove all traces of iTunes in your computer completely. Uninstall, delete all the ones that say Apple, Apple support, everything like that. And then you're going to want to download the Jailbreak tool. So head to their website, download the Jailbreak tool. Then you're going to want to open the Jailbreak tool. Now, this device is plugged in already. The tool is going to check the Jailbreak environment, and now it's going to tell us that the device can't, or the Apple driver can't be found. Head to this website when you click on it here. Now, if you guys want this is a translated version, you need to pick the 32 or 64-bit version, depending on which one you guys want. So after that is downloaded, go to your downloads folder, start the install, and I have the install right here, so I'm just going to allow this to run while we're doing this. You can now close the TaiG app here. On the iPad, iPhone, whichever one you're working with, you're going to want to go to the iCloud setting here and either sign out or turn off the Find My iPhone feature that will be down over here. This is because it needs to be turned off for the Jailbreak to succeed. The second thing you're going to want to do is head to passcode here and turn off this passcode. There can't be a locked passcode on your device during this time. So once you have those done, and we'll just be finishing up with iTunes, looks like it's going to finish here. What you're going to want to do after we've installed the iTunes is basically double check that everything is connected, that you are not using the iPad. We'll just allow this to finish here. This process is kind of sped up for you guys, but it could take you a few minutes to actually do this jailbreak because you need to downgrade to iTunes 12.0.1 to do this. So even if there was a Mac version available, this would still be the case, as Apple removed some key drivers that are used in injecting and installing the jailbreak is kind of an easy way to put it. My computer's going as fast as it can go on a virtual machine here, and we're basically done. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to unplug and plug the device back in. There we go. I am going to open iTunes, which will take a second here. And now, to verify that this iTunes is going to work, and this is very key to having no issue, is if you go to the About iTunes there, this is 12.0.1626, sorry. So this iTunes is the version you guys need to get through all the errors, the stuck at 20%, and so on. So once you open up that tool, once you've completed the install of the new iTunes, which is an old version of iTunes, you will now be able to continue on with the jailbreak. So, here we have two options. I'm just going to recommend until there's some updates to the jailbreak that you just leave both of them in there. And we're just going to basically start. So, allow, the device will reboot right away. And now we're on the infamous 20%. So, this can take a few minutes because it has to reboot 3 times. The last jailbreak took me probably 6 to 8 minutes just in the jailbreak process itself. It's not the fastest one, but it gets the job done. So as you can see here, iTunes opens up. You can just leave it alone. I'll minimize it so it's not in the way. I found this part to be a little stressful. You just have to kind of sit and wait for a few seconds there until it jumps to its 30%. Again, I haven't touched the device and you shouldn't neither. And now we're moving on to the 40 to 50% mark. And then you can see here it does kind of explain a little bit that it's injecting and executing. So it looks like a lot of that was just injection, or just the sneaking the jailbreak over, basically. So now we're getting the storage is almost full indication. And then after this, there will be the last reboot. And now at this point, you will be finished with the computer. The jailbreak has succeeded on the device. So you can actually unplug it, which I've done here. As we allow the device to boot up, you will still see the storage is full option. This is the exact same iPhone, iPad. What you want to do here is go to Ceadd, which will be installed either at the bottom of your first page or on your second page. You want to open this, and now you'll get a glitched out preparing system file screen. So that's it, you guys. This takes another minute or so, so I won't bore you guys with the final details. Or actually, yeah, I'll leave it and then show you guys Ceadd working. But if you follow all the steps, step by step, like I explained, you will be able to jailbreak successfully. Right in your search bar, if you guys are using Windows, it's simply Control Panel. Once you get into your Control Panel, you just want to go to Uninstall Programs. These applications here, the Apple software, mobile software, application support, and this one here, the iTunes, these all need to be uninstalled and reinstalled with that download that you get from inside the tag here. And that's basically it. Like I said, this does take a little bit of time. Preparing system files, back in the old jailbreaks, this used to be done during the jailbreak. They were known as RAM disks. It's not really popular anymore. I'm not too sure if it's just in the way the exploits are done or not, but it'd be kind of nice if the system files were set up during the jailbreak process. Throwing that out there for future jailbreaks. And just to show you guys too, when you plug the device back in after the jailbreak has succeeded, oops, that was probably not good. Go back to Ceadd. It will say the device is jailbroken here. So after that very, very long, painful wait, you will wait. It'll respring. Which, this, if you're new to jailbreaking, a respring is like a soft reboot. It's not a full reboot, but it's like a springboard. Springboard is what we call what we see here. You guys, like, as you use, like, this is a springboard app. This is a springboard background, so on and so forth. So anyways, so now Ceadd will be, here you go, fully functioning and on iOS 8.3. So there you go, guys. Thanks for watching. Rate, comment, subscribe, and we'll see you again next video. Cheers.